तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः वी आर इन पंचदशी चैप्टर 14 एंड वर्स नंबर 63 Here the teacher, the seeker, was continuously singing or screaming in gratitude out of the bliss that he is experiencing. Not the seeker, the person who has come to know himself. Dhanyoham dhanyoham trupter me kopama bhavet loke. Dhanyoham dhanyoham dhanyo dhanya puna puna dhanyaha. Again and again, contentment, I am blessed, and he is expressing his gratitude again and again. He can't imagine that, there's no imagination here, that it has happened to him, that he has come to know. This is the mind speaking, you know. The mind is saying dhanyoham dhanyoham, and therefore I find myself manifold blessed, and there is no simile for my contentment in this world. How can any worldly contentment be compared with mine? There is no experience in this world, there is no object or person in this world, nothing in this time, space and objectivity can come even close to the contentment that I am experiencing at this moment. And it is a infinite source of joy that this wise man is experiencing, and in front of it all these finite joys have got no meaning whatsoever. The fulfillment is also on remembering the culmination of merit in the past. Huh? Why do we, at the individual level, why do we collect merit? At individual level, why do we collect merit? Why we are told to collect merit? So that the Lord, you go to heavens, in the end, go to, based on those merits, you go to higher and higher worlds, isn't it? But here, this is any world you go to, there is always a possibility of coming back. It is not a permanent abode. But this one is, there is no returning into the human realm. And if there is, not as you know it, it will be the Lord's will. He is not there to say anything. And therefore he says, अहो पुण्यम अहो पुण्यम अहो पुण्यम अहो पुण्यम फलितम फलितम दृढ़म फलितम फलितम दृढ़म अस्य पुण्यस्य संपत्तेः अस्य पुण्यस्य संपत्तेः अहो वयम अहो वयम अहो वयम अहो वयम द मेरिट्स ऑफ द पास्ट हैव रीच्ड फुल मैच्योरिटी In attaining this state of blessedness, it is indeed a great joy and fulfillment to have acquired such a merit. What is the ultimate? Why do you want to go to heaven? Why do you want to go to higher worlds? Only to experience the bliss, isn't it? experience bliss. Why do we want more and more things in our life? And this is what was told in the Taittiriya Upanishad. The various anandas. The various anandas, and the ultimate was the abode of Lord Brahmaji, the creator. But Brahmaji at that totality level also comes and goes. Also comes and goes. But and for that we keep accruing more and more merit by doing good deeds, by chanting the name of the Lord, by doing tapasya, by charity, by pilgrimages, by being in the company of the great masters. That is why we are doing all this. And somewhere in the back of our mind we know all this is creating good wives and good memories. But what is the ultimate joy, the ultimate bliss from where there is no coming back is what this wise man has come to abide in. My punya karma has borne fruit in a very firm, enduring way. Even though this punya, this blessing is of the infinite, it is of the Lord, but this is the mind speaking, not the wise man speaking. The mind is feeling. My punya karma, my good deeds have borne fruit in a very fine, enduring way. My sadhana is fulfilled. Oh, the great merit that I have acquired on the strength of the spiritual sadhana and all the punyas, that is the merits I have done. I have today arrived at the right destination of my life. We must not run after the small ephemeral things. We should not run after the finite. Go out, run after the infinite. And then ha hu ha hu. Taittiriya Upanishad, the student, he speaks as he's contemplating. Ha hu, because he doesn't have words to express. Then all he can say is ha. That's all is going on. He says, I don't know whether I am the body or not the body. I don't know whether I am breathing or not breathing. I don't care whether I am the mind or not the mind. I don't care whether I am thinking or not thinking. I don't care whether truth is a concept or not a concept. I am, bas. I am nothing also and I am everything also. What can you... You cannot come to a conclusive answer about the self. At a mental level, mind cannot come to know the truth. So it will only say something. It is bound to say something. And yet at another level, he is experiencing that all the nothing and everything is manifestation and unmanifestation is he alone. There is no running away anywhere. All those factors that have helped me in arriving at the self-knowledge are also contributors to fulfillment. Aho Shastram, Aho Shastram, Aho Shastram, Aho Shastram, Aho Guru, Aho Guru, Aho Guru, Aho Guru, Aho Jnanam, Aho Jnanam, Aho Jnanam, Aho Jnanam, Aho Sukham, Aho Sukham, Aho Sukham, Aho Sukham. Great are indeed the scriptures that gave the knowledge. Great is indeed the Guru who revealed the scriptural knowledge to me. Great is the self-knowledge. The greatest is the bliss of self-knowledge. So we must not forget yesterday I met someone. She said, Swamiji, I'm doing this Kriya and everything, and it has really helped me. I was going in the negative way. My mind was continuously going into self-pity, it was going into judgments, and very, very negative. And slowly, I was not liking, I was recognizing it is going, and by default, those type of responses were coming, but I was not enjoying. I knew something had to be done. And my mind was always, there was no energy in my body, the disease, the operation, this, that. And I started doing some pranayama exercise, Kriya Yoga. And now I'm getting so much energy. I said, very good. See? Oh, but I didn't want to go to any course where they charge money. But then my friend forced me to go, and I did it. And it's really helping. I said, fantastic. Why do you create some... create a, what you call, a concept that without payment only things can be had, or with payments only things should be had. Be free. If it feels right, go after it. So she wanted to, she says, all these, everything that has happened in my life has brought me to this point where I'm feeling so good about myself. I said, very good. See? So here, we must not discard the scriptures. This under a point comes where you don't need scriptures. But that does not mean scriptures are no good. Some people say, oh, scripture is just, you are reading from the scriptures, you are talking about the scriptures, it is not your experience. Who says? Who are you to judge? The thinking, the technology, the way to approach is so distinctly given in the scriptures. Left alone, we will only think about the world. That systematically, we can never think about the truth. Isn't it? And without a teacher, without a Guru Maharaj, who can explain to us those scriptures in a joyful, meaningful communication, that is also required. See, sometimes the children are the best teachers, because with very innocently they tell the truth, isn't it? And we have to read scriptures to find the truth, but they are there. Even greater than the scriptures and the teacher is the self-knowledge. That now you don't need anything. You don't need the scriptures, you don't need the Guru Maharaj. You are absolutely clear that you are. But when that self-knowledge, when it starts expressing as unadulterated bliss every moment of your existence, that is the ultimate, that is the climax. This is what the student, the wise man is experiencing. Every remembrance of the scriptures, teacher, etc. brings the joy of being in their care during sadhana and now having arrived at one's real abode. See, one Mahatma, I told you this many times before. Once one Mahatma was reading Bhagavad Gita and someone asked, Swamiji, you are realized, why are you reading Bhagavad Gita? He says, I'm seeing what it is talking about me.
See?
So one must be grateful towards all those, all that and all those who have been directly or indirectly been helpful in your journey to where you are today. And that does not mean you can do it by going to them, but in your mind that disposition of gratitude should be there and ultimately to the Lord, because scriptures are his speech. Oh Lord, thank you
for choosing me, for giving me the opportunity, for making me understand. Don't say I understood everything, no. For making me understand, for creating the right doubt so that my growth could be, could move, you know, I could move further. And in this way, and when we are doing our exercises, when we are doing our chintanam, contemplation, nididhyasana, sharanam, madanam, mananam, nididhyasanam, when we are doing our meditation, sometimes we get lost, then we go to one satsang and again something clicks and again we find ourselves on the track. So don't undermine the importance of satsang, don't undermine the importance of a teacher in life, don't undermine the importance of scriptures in life, don't undermine the importance of daily practice. Daily practice of what? Wherever you find yourself. Every day you cannot do chintanam. Some days you may want to just chant the name of the Lord. Some days you may just want to be active in the world and just your attention is on the world. Wherever Lord, whatever the Lord prompts from within. As in most of the chapters, the concluding shloka describes the benefits of the study and reflection on this chapter, that is Phalashruti. So what is the Phalashruti? Brahmananda vidhe grandhe
Chaturtho dhyaya iritaha
Vidyanandastadutpatti Paryantobhyasa ishyatam He says, Brahmananda vidhe granthe chaturthodhyaya iritaha. So he says this fourth chapter of the section called Vidyananda in the book titled Brahmananda. See, this chapter was called what? Brahmananda Vidyanande. Study and practice of this is expected until the attainment of that bliss. So what do? Keep repeating this chapter again and again and again and again. Phalashruti, as in all other chapters, the last verse gives a guidance and effect of the study of that chapter. Here also the author gives us an advice about the continuity of one spiritual sadhana till the bliss of self is realized, referred to here as Vidyananda. So what is Vidya? Vidya is the knowledge. So continue practicing this knowledge till you come to abide. This is how you move around in the world. You have the knowledge that you are hungry, then you go after food. You have the knowledge that you need to lose weight, you start exercising. You have the knowledge that you are feeling sleepy, you come to know, isn't it? And you go after sleep. Similarly, once you have come to know that you are of the nature of the self, then go after the self. Practice, practice, practice. Today Stanton was telling me,
yeah, he had just come, that his
His wife's son, from previous marriage,
he bought a virtual reality studio, a small 2x2 meters room, and he says, Swamiji, you have to experience it. He is inside, put the goggles on, he's inside, and he says, you are in a different world.
Everything you touch, feel, taste, everything is like that. And but it's all virtual. So
Taste also.
But I don't know. This is the first version. As we move ahead, it will come. And then we're just doing the wood. I said, so what else? He says, I realized that 2 by 2 meter box could give me such a sensory experience, and I took, while I was experiencing it, it was very real. I'm touching, I'm feeling, and I'm getting that sensation. And when I came out of it, I realized this world is also the same. It is also virtual. Also virtual, because
ego is virtual.
Everything that is existing
is actually what we see is
as we see it. It is not existing like that. It's only imagination that it is like that.
That there is a form, that there is a sound, that there is a taste. Reality is something different.
We are seeing water, but calling it a wave. We are
seeing reality, but calling it the world.
We are the spirit, but we call ourselves individual. And we don't stop there. Then we say we are
the ego.
So the more we study
like this, what was this chapter about?
This chapter was about the bliss of wisdom, Brahmanande Vidyananda, the bliss of wisdom. And here, the differences in Supreme Self and conditioned self was inquired into, and
position of Agami and Sanchit Karma for the man of wisdom, that Agami, those karmas that have not
that have not formed yet, and Sanchit Karma, that all that he has accrued with the past actions, they become null and void for a man of wisdom, because
he is not available to them. That is, and when actions are taking place without a doer, then there is no precipitation of impressions or memories. And this was told.
Then second kind of Vidyananda, fulfillment of desire, etc., for the man of wisdom. So here the four things were told,
that
for this man of wisdom, the knowledge of the bliss of knowledge comes about by four things, four impetuses.
First is dukkha abhava,
that absence of misery brought about the bliss, brings about the
bliss. This knowledge brings about the bliss that I am not miserable. And what is the definition of misery?
That I am not the mind.
Or
not think, coming to this conclusion that by, if I think that I am, it is not necessary I am in spite of thinking. So dukkha abhav, whatever which way you look at it, absence of misery brings about bliss. Then second was what? Kamaptihi. The kamaptihi is fulfillment of desires. And it was told here that in a wise man, no misery ever remains. In a wise man, as a result of self-realization, all the desires remain fulfilled at all times. And therefore, when he is come to realize that he is everything and everywhere at the same time, then what can he desire? See? In other words, all his desires are, this is the understanding given, that in one go, having gained the self, having, once he becomes one with the self, as self, after that, or at that very moment, all the desires are simultaneously satisfied once and for all. And the third one was
Krutakrutyata, that is, whatever has been done. Nothing more needs to be done in order to gain contentment. So that gives him a sense of fulfillment. And that leads to praptasya praptihi, that whatever has to be gained has already been gained. That also gives the bliss. So krutakrutyata gave fulfillment, that nothing needs to be done. In what regards? Not only in the worldly sense, but also with regards to realizing the self. Because what can I do? I am already. If I am already, then mind is thinking, let it think. Mind is thinking, I am, let it think. Does not matter. You remain. this realization that I am in spite of thinking is what brings about krutakrutyata. Nothing needs to be done anymore. And then the last one was praptasya praptihi. Now there is no urge to possess anything, to own anything. Why? Everything that needs to be gained in life, I have already gained. The last verse told you that, isn't it? And in this way, various degrees of bliss for different levels of existence and the bliss enjoyed by the man of wisdom. So there the Taittiriya Upanishad was quoted, and it was told that about the king who has, first level was the king who has, who is the emperor, monarch of the whole world, having he's a youth, all the subjects love him, he has all the wealth, everything. What will he desire? He will not desire anything, because everything is at his fingertips. But one day he will die. One day some other person can come and take away things from him. It is not for that bliss that he is experiencing. He is content. But how long will his contentment last? Till the next person comes and demands it from him. Whereas the man of wisdom, he is far, far, far beyond that. He is not afraid of any loss. And then the third and the fourth aspects of Vidyananda, which was krutakrutyata and praptasya prapti, these were taken in the last few verses. And the last verse that we saw is Phalashruti, Brahmananda Vide Grante, Chaturthodhyaya Iritaha, Vidyanandas Tadutpattihi, Paryanto Bhyasa Ishyatam. And in this way, that in Brahmananda, everything is included. Nothing is outside of Brahmananda. And that I am. Therefore, no desire, nothing to do, nowhere to go, no misery. So with this, the chapter gets concluded. The next chapter will be on the four Mahavakyas. Tattvamasi, Prajnanam Brahma, Ayamatma Brahma, Ayamatma Brahma and Aham Brahmasmi. These are the four main Mahavakyas in our Upanishads. And it's a very short chapter, and it will, within how many verses are there? 35 verses. In 35 verses, all these four Mahavakyas will be looked into. And why it is so short? What more can you talk about when they are talked about everything beforehand? Now this is the creme de la creme, the ultimate. We can chant this chapter if you want. We've got some time. You can repeat after me.
ज्ञानात्मविवेकेन योगेनात्मविवेकेन द्वैतमिथ्यात्वचिन्तया द्वैतमिथ्यात्वचिन्तया ब्रह्मानन्दं पश्यतोथ ब्रह्मानन्दं पश्यतोथ विद्यानन्दो निरूप्यते ब्रह्मानन्दो निरूप्यते विषयानन्दवद्विद्या विषयानन्दवद्विद्या नन्दोधिवृत्तिरूपकः नन्दोधिवृत्तिरूपकः दुःखाभावादिरूपेण दुःखाभावादिरूपेण प्रोक्त एष चतुर्विधः प्रोक्त एष चतुर्विधः दुःखाभावश्च कामाप्तिः दुःखाभावश्च कामाप्तिः कृतकृत्योऽहमित्यसौ कृतकृत्योऽहमित्यसौ प्राप्तप्राप्योऽहमित्येव प्राप्तप्राप्योऽहमित्येव चातुर्विद्यमुदाहृतं चातुर्विद्यमुदाहृतम् ऐहिकं चामुष्मिकं चेति ऐहिकं चामुष्मिकं चेति एवं दुःखं द्विधेरितम् एवं दुःखं द्विधेरितं निवृत्तिमैहिकस्याः निवृत्तिमैहिकस्याः बृहदारण्यकं वचः बृहदारण्यकं वचः आत्मानं चेद्विजानीयात् आत्मानं चेद्विजानीयात् अहमस्मीति पुरुषः अहमस्मीति पुरुषः किमिच्छन् कस्य कामाय किमिच्छन् कस्य कामाय शरीरमनुसंज्वरेत् शरीरमनुसंज्वरेत् जीवात्मा परमात्मा चेति जीवात्मा परमात्मा चेति आत्मा द्विविध ईरितः आत्मा द्विविध ईरितः चित्तादात्म्यात् त्रिभिर्देहैः चित्तादात्म्यात् त्रिभिर्देहैः जीवसन्भोक्तृतां व्रजेत् जीवसन्भोक्तृतां व्रजेत् परमात्मा सच्चिदानन्दः परमात्मा सच्चिदानन्दः तादात्म्यं नामरूपयोः तादात्म्यं नामरूपयोः गत्वा भोग्यत्वमापन्नः गत्वा भोग्यत्वमापन्नः तद्विवेके तु नो भयं तद्विवेके तु नो भयम् भोग्यमिच्छन् भोक्तुरर्थे भोग्यमिच्छन् भोक्तुरर्थे शरीरमनुसंज्वरेत् अनुसंज्वरेत् ज्वराश्रिषु शरीरेषु ज्वराश्रिषु शरीरेषु स्थिता नत्वात्मनो ज्वराः त्वात्मनो ज्वराः व्याधयो धातु वैषम्ये धयो धातु वैषम्ये स्थूलदेहे स्थिता ज्वराः देहे स्थिता ज्वराः कामक्रोधादय सूक्ष्मे कामक्रोधादय सूक्ष्मे द्वयोर्बीजं तु कारणे द्वयोर्बीजं तु कारणे अद्वैतानन्दमार्गेण अद्वैतानन्दमार्गेण परात्मनि विवेचिते परात्मनि विवेचिते अपश्यन् वास्तवं भोग्यम्
शन वास्तवं भोग्यं किं नामे चेत् परात्मवित किं नामे चेत् परात्मवित आत्मानन्दोक्तरित्यास्मिन् आत्मानन्दोक्तरित्यास्मिन् जीवात्मन्यवधारिते जीवात्मन्यवधारिते भोक्ता नैवास्ति कोऽप्यत्र भोक्ता नैवास्ति कोऽप्यत्र शरीरे तु ज्वर कुतः शरीरे तु ज्वर कुतः पुण्यपापद्वये चिन्ता पुण्यपापद्वये चिन्ता दुःखमामुष्मिकं भवेत् दुःखमामुष्मिकं भवेत् प्रथमाध्याय एवोक्तं प्रथमाध्याय एवोक्तं चिन्तानैनं तपेदिति चिन्तानैनं तपेदिति यथा पुष्करपर्णेऽस्मिन् यथा पुष्करपर्णेऽस्मिन् अपामश्लेषणं तथा अपामश्लेषणं तथा वेदनादूर्ध्वमागामी वेदनादूर्ध्वगामी कर्मणोश्लेषणं बुधे कर्मणोश्लेषणं बुधे इशिकातृणतूलस्य वह्निदाह क्षणाद्यथा वह्निदाह क्षणाद्यथा तथा संचित कर्मास्य कर्मास्य दग्धं भवति वेदनात् दग्धं भवति वेदनात् यथैधांसी समेद्धोग्निः भस्मसात् कुरुतेऽर्जुन भस्मसात् कुरुतेऽर्जुन ज्ञानाग्निसर्वकर्माणि भस्मसात् कुरुते तथा भस्मसात् कुरुते तथा यस्य नाहंकृतो भावो यस्य नाहंकृतो भावो बुद्धिर्यस्य न लिप्यते बुद्धिर्यस्य न लिप्यते हत्वापि स इमान् लोकान् हत्वापि स इमान् लोकान् न हन्ति न निबध्यते न हन्ति न निबध्यते माता पित्रोर्वधस्तेयं माता पित्रोर्वधस्तेयं भ्रूणहत्यान्यदीदृशं भ्रूणहत्यान्यदीदृशं न मुक्तिं नाशयेत् पापं न मुक्तिं नाशयेत् पापं मुखकान्तिर्न नश्यति मुखकान्तिर्न नश्यति दुःखाभाववदेवास्य दुःखाभाववदेवास्य सर्वकामाप्तिरीरिता सर्वकामाप्तिरीरिता सर्वान् कामानसावाप्त्वा सर्वान् कामानसावाप्त्वा यमृतो भवदित्यतः यमृतो भवदित्यतः जक्षन् क्रीडन् रतिं प्राप्तः जक्षन् क्रीडन् रतिं प्राप्तः स्त्रीभिर्यानैस्तथेतरैः स्त्रीभिर्यानैस्तथेतरैः शरीरं न स्मरेत् प्राणः शरीरं न स्मरेत् प्राणः कर्मणा जीवयेद् मुमं कर्मणा जीवयेद् मुमं सर्वान् कामान् सहाप्नोति सर्वान् कामान् सहाप्नोति नान्यवज्जन्मकर्मभिः नान्यवज्जन्मकर्मभिः वर्तन्ते श्रोत्रिये भोगा वर्तन्ते श्रोत्रिये भोगाः युगपत्क्रमज्वर्जिताः युगपत्क्रमवर्जिताः युवारूपीन युवारूपी च विद्यावान् विद्यावान् नीरोगो दृढचित्तवान् नीरोगो दृढचित्तवान् सैन्योपेतः सर्वपृथ्वीं सैन्योपेतः सर्वपृथ्वीं वित्तपूर्णां प्रपालयन् वित्तपूर्णां प्रपालयन् सर्वैर्मानुष्यकैर्भोगैः सर्वैर्मानुष्यकैर्भोगैः सम्पन्नस्तृप्तभूमिपः सम्पन्नस्तृप्तभूमिपः यमानन्दमवाप्नोति यमानन्दमवाप्नोति ब्रह्मविच्छतमश्नुते ब्रह्मविच्छनमश्नुते मर्त्यभोगे द्वयोर्नास्ति मर्त्यभोगे द्वयोर्नास्ति कामस्तृप्तिरतः समा कामस्तृप्तिरतः समा भोगान्निष्कामतैकस्य भोगान्निष्कामतैकस्य परस्यापि विवेकतः यापि विवेकतः श्रोत्रियत्वाद्वे वेदशास्त्रैः श्रोत्रियात् श्रोत्रियत्वाद्वेदशास्त्रैः श्रोत्रियत्वाद्वेदशास्त्रैः भोगदोषानवेक्षते भोगदोषानवेक्षते राजा बृहद्रथो दोषान् राजा बृहद्रथो दोषान् तान् गाथाभिरुदाहरत तान् गाथाभिरुदाहरत देहदोषांश्चित्तदोषान् देहदोषांश्चित्तदोषान् भोग्यदोषाननेकषः भोग्यदोषाननेकषः शुनावान्ते पायसे नो शुनावान्ते पायसे नो कामस्तद्वद्विवेकिनः कामस्तद्वद्विवेकिनः निष्कामत्वे समेऽप्यत्र निष्कामत्वे समेऽप्यत्र राज्ञसाधनसञ्चये राज्ञसाधनसञ्चये दुःखमासीद्भाविनाशात् दुःखमासीद्भाविनाशात् अतिभिरनुवर्तते अतिभिरनुवर्तते नो भयं श्रोत्रियस्यातः नो भयं श्रोत्रियस्यातः तदानन्दोऽधिको न्यतः तदानन्दोऽधिको न्यतः गन्धर्वानन्द आशास्ति नन्द आशास्ति राज्ञो नास्ति विवेकिनः नास्ति विवेकिनः अस्मिन् कल्पे मनुष्य सन् अस्मिन् कल्पे मनुष्य सन् पुण्यपाकविशेषतः पुण्यपाकविशेषतः गन्धर्वत्वं समापन्नो गन्धर्वत्वं समापन्नो मर्त्यगन्धर्व उच्यते मर्त्यगन्धर्व उच्यते पूर्वकल्पे कृतात् पुण्यात् पूर्वकल्पे कृतात् पुण्यात् कल्पादावेव चेत् भवेत्, कल्पादावेव चेत् भवेत्। गन्धर्वत्वं तादृशोत्र, गन्धर्वत्वं तादृशोत्र। देवगन्धर्व उच्यते, देवगन्धर्व उच्यते। अग्निष्वातादयो लोके, अग्निष्वातादयो लोके, दयो लोके पितरश्चिरवासिनः, पितरश्चिरवासिनः। कल्पादावेव देवत्वं, कल्पादावेव देवत्वं। गता आजान देवताः, गता आजा देवताः। अस्मिन् कल्पेष्वमेधादी, पेष्वमेधादी। कर्म कृत्वा महत्पदम्, महत्पदम्। अवाप्या जान देवैर्याः, अवाप्या जान देवैर्याः, अवाप्या जान देवैर्याः। पूज्यास्ता कर्म देवताः, पूज्यास्ता कर्म देवताः। यमाग्निमुख्या देवास्युः, अग्निमुख्या देवास्युः। ज्ञातावीन्द्रबृहस्पति, ज्ञातावीन्द्रबृहस्पति। प्रजापतिर्विराट् प्रोक्तो, प्रजापतिर्विराट् प्रोक्तो। ब्रह्मा सूत्रात्मना मकः, ब्रह्मा सूत्रात्मना मकः। सार्वभौमादिसूत्रान्ता, सार्वभौमादिसूत्रान्ता। उत्तरोत्तरकामिनः, उत्तरोत्तरकामिनः। अवाङ्मनसगम्योऽयम्, अवाङ्मनसगम्योऽयम्। आत्मानन्दस्ततः परः, आत्मानन्दस्ततः परः। तैस्तैकाम्येषु सर्वेषु, तैस्तैकाम्येषु सर्वेषु। सुखेषु श्रोत्रियो यतः, सुखेषु श्रोत्रियो यतः। निःस्पृहस्तेन सर्वेषां, निःस्पृहस्तेन सर्वेषाम्। आनन्दा सन्ति तस्य ते, आनन्दा सन्ति तस्य ते। सर्वकामाप्तिरेशोक्ता, सर्वकामाप्तिरेशोक्ता। यद्वा साक्षि चिदात्मना, यद्वा साक्षि चिदात्मना। स्वदेहवत् सर्वदेहेषु, स्वदेहवत् सर्वदेहेषु। अपि भोगान वेक्षते, अपि भोगान वेक्षते। अज्ञस्याप्येतदस्त्येव, अज्ञस्याप्येतदस्त्येव। न तु तृप्तिरबोधतः, न तु तृप्तिरबोधतः। यो वेद सोष्णुते सर्वान्, यो वेद सोष्णुते सर्वान्। कामान्नित्यब्रवीत् श्रुतिः, कामान्नित्यब्रवीत् श्रुतिः। यद्वा सर्वात्मतां स्वस्य, सर्वात्मतां स्वस्य। साम्ना गायति सर्वदा, साम्ना गायति सर्वदा। अहमन्नं तथा नादः, अहमन्नं तथा नादः। चेति सामह्यधीयते, चेति साम्यम, चेति सामह्यमिद्, चेति सामह्यधीयते, चेति सामह्यधीयते। दुःखाभावश्च कामाप्तिः, दुःखाभावश्च कामाप्तिः। उभयेवं निरूपिते, उभे एवं निरूपिते। कृतकृत्यत्वमन्यच्च, कृतकृत्यत्वमन्यच्च। प्राप्त प्राप्यत्वमीक्षताम् प्राप्त प्राप्यत्वमीक्षताम् उभयं तृप्तिदीपेहि उभयं तृप्तिदीपेहि सम्यगस्माभिरीरितं सम्यगस्माभिरीरितं स त एवानुसन्धेयाः स एवात्रानुसन्धेयाः श्लोका बुद्धि विशुद्धये श्लोका बुद्धि विशुद्धये ऐहिकामुष्मिकव्रात ऐहिकामुष्मिकव्रात सिद्ध्यै मुक्तेश्च सिद्धये सिद्ध्यै मुक्तेश्च सिद्धये बहुकृत्यं पुरास्याभूत् पुरास्याभूत् तत्सर्वमधुना कृतं तत्सर्वमधुना कृतं तदेतत्कृतकृत्यत्वं तदेतत्कृतकृत्यत्वं प्रतियोगी पुरःसरं प्रतियोगी पुरःसरम् अनुसन्दधदेवायम् अनुसन्दधदेवायम् एवं तृप्यति नित्यशः एवं तृप्यति नित्यशः दुःखिनोज्ञा संसरन्तु दुःखिनोज्ञा संसरन्तु कामं पुत्राद्यपेक्षया कामं पुत्राद्यपेक्षया परमानन्दपूर्णोऽहं परमानन्दपूर्णोऽहं संसरामि किमिच्छया संसरामि किमिच्छया अनुतिष्ठन्तु कर्माणि अनुतिष्ठन्तु कर्माणि परलोकयया सवः परलोकयया सवः सर्वलोकात्मक कस्मात् सर्वलोकात्मक कस्मात् अनुतिष्ठामि किं कथम् अनुतिष्ठामि किं कथम् व्याचक्षतां ते शास्त्राणि व्याचक्षतां ते शास्त्राणि वेदानध्यापयतु वा वेदानध्यापयतु वा येत्राधिकारिणो मे तु येत्राधिकारिणो मे तु नाधिकारो क्रियत्वतः नाधिकारो क्रियत्वतः निद्राभिक्षे स्नान शौचे निद्राभिक्षे स्नान शौचे नेच्छामि न करोमि च नेच्छामि न करोमि च द्रष्टारश्चेत् कल्पयन्ति द्रष्टारश्चेत् कल्पयन्ति किं मे स्यादन्य कल्पनात् किं मे स्यादन्य कल्पनात् गुञ्जापुञ्जादिदह्येत गुञ्जापुञ्जादिदह्येत नान्यारोपितवान् वाह्निना नान्यारोपितवाह्निना नान्यरोपितसंसार नान्यारोपितसंसार धर्मानेवमहं भजे धर्मानेवमहं भजे शृण्वन्त्वज्ञाततत्त्वास्ते शृण्वन्त्वज्ञाततत्त्वास्ते न जानन् कस्मात् शृणोम्यहं जानन् कस्मात् शृणोम्यहं मन्यन्तां संशयापन्नाः मन्यन्तां संशयापन्नाः न मन्येऽहमसंशयः न मन्येऽहमसंशयः विपर्यस्तो निदिध्यासेत् विपर्यस्तो निदिध्यासेत् किं ध्यानम् अविपर्ययात् किं ध्यानम् अविपर्ययात्
దేహాత్మత్వవిపర్యాసం దేహాత్మత్వవిపర్యాసం న కదాచిద్ భజామ్యహం న కదాచిద్ భజామ్యహం అహం మనుష్య ఇత్యాది అహం మనుష్య ఇత్యాది వ్యవహారో వినా ప్యూయం వ్యవహారో వినా యముం విపర్యాసం విచారంభ్యస్త విచార్యాసం విచారభ్యస్త వాసనాతో వకల్ప్యతే వాసనాతో వికల్ప్యతే ప్రారబ్ధకర్మణి క్షీణే ప్రారబ్ధకర్మణి క్షీణే వ్యవహారో నివర్తతే వ్యవహారో నివర్తతే కర్మాక్షయే త్వసౌ నైవ కర్మాక్షయే త్వసౌ నైవ శామ్యే ధ్యాన సహస్రతః శామ్యే ధ్యాన సహస్రతః విరళత్వం వ్యవహృతే విరళత్వం వ్యవహృతే ఇష్టం చేద్ ధ్యానమస్తుతే ఇష్టం చేద్ ధ్యానమస్తుతే అబాధికాం వ్యవహృతిం అబాధికాం వ్యవహృతిం పశ్యన్ ధ్యాయామ్యహం కుతః పశ్యన్ ధ్యాయామ్యహం కుతః విక్షేపో నాస్తి యస్మాన్ మే విక్షేపో నాస్తి యస్మాన్ మే న సమాధిస్తతో మమ న సమాధిస్తతో మమ విక్షేపో వా సమాధిర్వా విక్షేపో వా సమాధిర్వా మనస స్యాద్ వికారిణః మనస స్యాద్ వికారిణః నిత్యానుభవరూప్యస్య నిత్యానుభవరూపస్య కో మే వానుభవ పృథక కో మే వానుభవ పృథక కృతం కృత్యం ప్రాపణీయం కృతం కృత్యం ప్రాపణీయం ప్రాప్తమిత్యేవ నిశ్చయః ప్రాప్తమిత్యేవ నిశ్చయః వ్యవహారో లౌకికో వా వ్యవహారో లౌకికో వా శాస్త్రీయో వాన్యథాపి వా శాస్త్రీయో థాపి వా మమాకర్తురలేపస్య మమాకర్తురలేపస్య యథారబ్ధం ప్రవర్తతాం యథారబ్ధం ప్రవర్తతాం అథవా కృతకృత్యోపి కృతకృత్యోపి లోకానుగ్రహకామ్యయా లోకానుగ్రహకామ్యయా శాస్త్రీయేణైవ మార్గేణ శాస్త్రీయేణైవ మార్గేణ వర్తేహం కామమ క్షతిః హం కామమ క్షతిః దేవార్చనస్నానశౌచ దేవార్చనస్నానశౌచ భిక్షాదౌ వర్తతాం వపుః భిక్షాదౌ వర్తతాం వపుః తారం జపతు వాక్ తద్వత తారం జపతు వాక్ తద్వత పఠత్వాం నాయమస్తకం త్వాం నాయమస్తకం విష్ణుం ధ్యాయతు ధీర్యద్వా విష్ణుం ధ్యాయతు ధీర్యద్వా బ్రహ్మానందే విలీయతాం బ్రహ్మానందే విలీయతాం సాక్ష్యహం కించిదప్యత్ర సాక్ష్యహం కించిదప్యత్ర న కుర్వేనాపి కారయే న కుర్వేనాపి కారయే కృతకృత్యతయా తృప్తః కృతకృత్యతయా తృప్తః ప్రాప్త ప్రాప్యతయా పునః ప్రాప్త ప్రాప్యతయా పునః తృప్యనేవం స్వమనసా तृप्यनेवं स्वमनसा मन्यते सौ निरन्तरं मन्यते सौ निरन्तरं धन्योऽहं धन्योः धन्योऽहं धन्योऽहं नित्यं धन्योऽहं नित्यं स्वात्मानमञ्जसा वेद्मि स्वात्मानमञ्जसा वेद्मि धन्योऽहं धन्योऽहं ब्रह्मानन्दो विभाओ धन्योऽहं 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 ब्रह्मानन्दो विभाति मे स्पष्टम् विभाति मे स्पष्टम् विल चैंट दिस अगेन धन्योऽहं धन्योऽहं नित्यं धन्योऽहं धन्योऽहं नित्यं स्वात्मानं मञ्जसा वेद्मि स्वात्मानमञ्जसा वेद्मि धन्योऽहं धन्योऽहं ब्रह्मान् धन्योऽहं धन्योऽहं ब्रह्मा आनन्दो विभाति मे स्पष्टम् आनन्दो विभाति मे स्पष्टम् धन्योऽहं धन्योऽहं दुःखं धन्योऽहं धन्योऽहं दुःखं सांसारिकं न विक्षेद्य सांसारिकं न विक्षेद्य धन्योऽहं धन्योऽहं स्वस्य धन्योऽहं धन्योऽहं स्वस्य अज्ञानं पलायितं क्वापि अज्ञानं पलायितं क्वापि धन्योऽहं धन्योऽहं कर्तव्यं धन्योऽहं धन्योऽहं कर्तव्यं मे न विद्यते किञ्चित् मे न कथ्यते किञ्चित् धन्योऽहं धन्योऽहं प्राप्तव्यं हं प्राप्तव्यं सर्वमद्य सम्पन्नं सर्वमद्य सम्पन्नं धन्योऽहं धन्योऽहं तृप्तेः धन्योऽहं धन्योऽहं तृप्तेः मे कोपमा भवेल्लोके मे कोपमा भवेल्लोके धन्योऽहं धन्योऽहं धन्यः धन्योऽहं धन्योऽहं धन्यः धन्य पुनः पुनर्धन्यः धन्य पुनर्धन्यः अहो पुण्यमहो पुण्यम् अहो पुण्यमहो पुण्यम् फलितं फलितं दृढं फलितं फलितं दृढम् अस्य पुण्यस्य सम्पत्तेः अस्य पुण्यस्य सम्पत्तेः अहो वयमहो वयम् अहो वयमहो वयम् अहो शास्त्रमहो शास्त्रम् अहो शास्त्रमहो शास्त्रम् अहो गुरुरहो गुरुः अहो गुरुरहो गुरुः अहो ज्ञानमहो ज्ञानम् अहो ज्ञानमहो ज्ञानम् अहो सुखमहो सुखम् अहो सुखमहो सुखम् ब्रह्मानन्दाभिधे ग्रन्थे ब्रह्मानन्दाभिधे ग्रन्थे चतुर्थोऽध्याय ईरितः चतुर्थोऽध्याय ईरितः विद्यानन्दस्तदुत्पत्ति विद्यानन्दस्तदुत्पत्ति पर्यन्तोऽभ्यास इष्यतां पर्यन्तोऽभ्यास इष्यतां हरि ओं तत्सत्
We'll chant the first verse again. Yo, got it? 1635.
Yogenatmavivekena, yogenatmavivekena, dvaitamithyatvachintaya, dvaitamithyatvachintaya, ब्रह्मानन्दं पश्यतोथ ब्रह्मानन्दं पश्यतोथ विद्यानन्दो निरूप्यते निरूप्यते
सो विथ दिस वी कम टू द कंक्लूजन Just recapping little bit.
Yes.
This wise man, fully content for having done his lot and gained the fulfillment of his life, thereafter continues again to experience this joy in his mind, having gained what he has to gain, which is himself. What is self-realization? Raising yourself in yourself, by yourself, for yourself. Uddharet atmanatmanam. By no other means, but by the self. And when that happens, that you come to be established in yourself, then what happens to such a person? After that, there is an experience of trupti, there is an experience of contentment, there is an experience of fulfillment, there is an experience of absence of misery, and there is an experience of all desires being fulfilled, and therefore infinite contentment. And such a person who is abiding in infinite bliss, the Paramananda, what else can he desire after that when he has the Paramananda? And therefore such a seeker, such a wise man, all that he can talk about or think about is dhanyoham, dhanyoham. I am blessed, I am indeed fulfilled because I have discovered my essential self. I am indeed fulfilled, for I have discovered the bliss of Brahman. It is distinctly clear to me. The realized master continues, having come to know himself, the mind is still there in the phenomena. What will that mind which has experienced its source, even though the mind cannot, it has surrendered to its source, and when it comes back, just like when you go to sleep, mind has vanished. The way you know your mind has vanished. When you wake up, what is your experience? Oh, that was a fantastic sleep. It was a very deep sleep. I am totally rejuvenated. Same thing you will say. When you come to abide in the self, the mind has surrendered into the self, to the source. When it comes back out, because the phenomena will continue till this body is there, then what will that mind talk about? It will only talk about the gratitude and the blessing that it has received. And because that, the just like after coming out of deep sleep, you are still experiencing the bliss of sleep. Similarly, imagine zillion, infinite times more potent, more homogeneous. Homogeneous means that which does not have any break in its continuum. The mind has experienced that homogeneous mass of bliss. It has realized that I am that. Aham Brahmasmi. Then what else can he talk? And therefore, he talks like this, that I am blessed. Then what else he says? I am indeed totally fulfilled, for the worldly sorrows are no more seen now. I am indeed content. Where has the ignorance of the self run away? Dhanyoham dhanyoham kartavyam mena vidyate kinche dhanyoham dhanyoham praptavyam sarvamadhya sampannam. I am indeed blessed, for not a bit of duty is left for me in this world. I am indeed fulfilled, for I have gained all that I had to gain in my life. That is the ultimate blessings. Our duty, first it is towards the world, towards our relatives, maybe we wean ourselves away from the family and the relatives, then it comes to the world. Then when we wean away from the world, then it comes to the self. Before coming to the self, it may come to the body. But once it catches that I must serve the self under all circumstances, then alone, abidance is possible, otherwise it is not. And in this way, having come to abide, what is more to be done? What more duties are there? Ultimate, when we talk about duties in this world, the ultimate duty is realization of the self. The purpose that we have got this human body is only for performing one duty, and that one duty is coming to recognize that we are of the nature of Paramananda.
infinite bliss. Nothing else. We are of the nature of Brahmanand. That is our purpose. And the only opportunity you have is, the window of opportunity is between the birth and death. That is your window. And when birth has already happened, when death will happen, we don't know. So take that opportunity by the reins
and ride it
to the self before
this body is unable to
support life,
before this phenomena becomes a
non-phenomena. And therefore,
धन्योहम धन्योहम तृप्तेर में कोपमा भवे लोके धन्योहम धन्योहम धन्यो धन्य पुनः पुनर्धन्या.
I find myself manifold blessed and there is no simile for my contentment in this world. How can any worldly contentment be compared with mine? There is nothing in this world that comes even close to this experience of the Paramanand, the Brahmanand, the Vidyanand that I am. See? Nothing.
And therefore,
this is the bestow. The self alone is the bestower of ultimate contentment. Nothing in the mind can give you contentment. Nothing in this world can give you contentment, because world is in the mind. And therefore, aho punyam aho punyam phalidam phalidam drudham asya punyasya sampattehe aho vayam aho vayam. This is, he's not just aho punyam aho punyam phalidam phalidam drudham asya punyasya sampattehe aho jayam aho vayam. He's not crying, man. Before we are crying.
He's saying this dhanyam
dhanyam out of joy, out of ecstasy. Aho punyam aho punyam phalitam phalitam drudam asya punyasya sampattehe aho vayam aho vayam. The merits of the past have reached full maturity. In attaining this state of blessedness, it is indeed a great joy and fulfillment to have acquired such a merit. As long as this doership is there, the mind had the previous program, no? That I must do. We have to go to heavens, I must do good deeds, I must not do bad deeds. So what is the ultimate? Why are you doing good deeds? To gain merit. Why do you want to gain merit? You want to go to heaven or higher lokas, higher worlds of experience, planes of experience. And what is the ultimate? It is the Brahman, it is the Paramatma. And he has attained that. And therefore he says, asya punyasya sampatti, when I have got the sampatti, when I am abiding in the wealth of the self, what other wealth will I gain? A want, it cannot be. Aho shastram, aho shastram, aho guru, aho guru, aho jnanam, aho jnanam, aho sukham, aho sukham. And here, having this ecstasy which is coming out now, he's remembering all the gratitude towards the scriptures, the guru, the knowledge and the bliss of knowledge. See, we must not underestimate the power of the scriptures. We must not say scriptures are not needed. We must not say and say only, I live according to my experience. But you can, no doubt everyone is having an experience, but who gives you that right angle of vision so that you can make that experience into a spiritual journey? Scriptures. Otherwise, you will be in the loop. One day you are talking very sublime, next day you are down in the dumps. Then what gives you that steadiness? What gives you that ability, that acumen to convert every experience of life so that it becomes a stepping stone or an impetus to fall back into
yourself, scriptures.
Mamdi? Like a template. This is the plan. Otherwise, if we go only after experiences, we will remain in the loop of the world. Experiences are only at the level of mind. Spirituality is not about going on one spectrum of the mind to the other spectrum of the mind. No, spirituality is going beyond the mind. It is not about experiencing the world. World will come to you, and you, your body, breath, mind, intellect have got no choice but to experience it. But to give undue value to the world. That is the no-no. So here he says, Aho Shastra, who tells us, who gives us the guidance, who gives us the pathway? The Shastras. And what are the Shastras? They are the speech of the Lord himself. They are not written by you, me, or any some person who has an axe to grind. Chalo, let's put these scriptures together and keep them in the loop. They'll be under my control. No. God, the way the Lord or the Paramatma has revealed these two great masters, it is to for you to recognize that you are that infinite. See, Nisargadatta Maharaj, when he went to his teacher, first time, only one lecture he attended. And that conclusion of that lecture, Nisargadatta Maharaj, being a shopkeeper and a businessman, came to thought, why is he telling me that I am infinite? And if he is telling me the technique also that I am the infinite, then he must be telling the truth, because he doesn't want anything in return. Scriptures don't want anything in return from you. The Guru doesn't want anything in return from you. The Lord does not want anything in return from you. Then it must be the truth. See how he convinced himself. So you have to find your way. But scriptures are the guidelines. And who makes that scripture palatable, understandable, how to unfold the subtle thoughts that are hidden within those verses? That is the Guru Maharaj or the teacher. Then, is he teaching you so that you become his disciple? No. Is he teaching so that you become his devotee and to serve him? No. Then what is the best service that you can do to him? To realize the truth that he is teaching you from the scriptures. And therefore it is told, Aho Jnanam, Aho Jnanam. See? Then first gratitude towards the scriptures, then gratitude towards the teacher, Guru Maharaj, and then gratitude towards the knowledge. Which knowledge? The knowledge of the self, which I have come to abide. I have become absolutely clear. There is no doubt. Now I don't even need someone to teach me. I don't need someone to tell me that you are the self. I know it. I got no doubt about it. And even greater than that knowledge is the bliss of that knowledge. You abide in that knowledge on the seat of meditation. You abide in that knowledge on the seat of meditation. But that bliss, then that knowledge which is of the nature of Sat Chit Ananda, then it expresses as the bliss in the when he comes out of the meditation. You are enjoying the movie with all its ups and downs and emotions, and it was fantastic. You are enjoying it, no doubt, but you don't want to spoil the whole thing because you're so intensely interacting with the movie. But when you come out of the movie, what do? You only sing glory of that movie. Oh, what a fantastic, I'm going to see it again. Same thing you say about deep sleep. I want to sleep again. Every day you want to sleep. And once you have tasted the self, as the self, there's no end to it. You want it all the moment. Not just once in a blue moon. And what is this? How can you make it a 24/7 experience? When you realize that this self that I am, this self-knowledge that you were very clear about, when you come to realize that this entire creation that I am in, that this mind, breath, body, people, space,
air, fire, water,
everything is nothing but that divinity.
That will give us the ananda.
That will give us the paramananda. And what is this paramananda or brahmananda? This brahmananda, knowledge of this is brahmananda. This brahmananda, coming to this conclusion, itself is brahmananda. And what is this brahmananda? Which is all inclusive. Nothing is outside of it. And that I am. Don't forget. Don't keep it a concept that, oh, Brahman is all inclusive. No, brahmananda is all inclusive. And that I am. Close your eyes.
पूर्णस्य
पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते।
ॐ शान्ति
शान्ति शान्ति। हरिः।